Hey, good afternoon, everyone. How's everyone doing today? Welcome to the Cultural Arts Center and our Conversation Coffee program today. Many of you know Ellen is not here today, so I'm filling in just for a moment, and then I'll pass it on to our wonderful artist. A quick note, today we're featuring some of our artists from our main gallery. That's why we're down here in the main hall today. So we have three artists from Art360 New Works. And I have to apologize too, I just got a phone call just a few minutes ago from our curator, Charles Busta. We had on the schedule he was going to be here today as well, but he is not feeling well today, so he was going to join us. But he is promised to be here next week, because we're featuring, next week we're going to have three more artists from this show who will be talking to us about the exhibition. And he has suggested he'll probably be better by then. And I think he even suggested he might have some treats to bring along, so make sure you stop back next Thursday as well. But for today, we have three wonderful artists from this show, and they're going to talk a little bit about their individual works, and talk a little bit about this project on the whole. This has been a project that's been ongoing for a little while, and they had a really cool exhibition last year at the museum that I'm sure they can share with you. So we have three artists today: Anihara, Marc Lincewicz, and April Tsunami. And today, starting off, we have Mark's going to go first. So he's got his work already up here on the easels. And I'll pass this off to him. So please welcome Marc Lincewicz.
Hi, everybody. My name is Marc Lincewicz, and I am a fine artist, and I also make my living at Information Line. So I run their in-house creative agency there. So designers, writers, photographers, I live and breathe this stuff. I love art, I love creating, as I'm sure you guys do too. I'm always nervous and humbled to stand in front of people to talk about art. I don't know if you ever had to do this, but it's tough, right? Because as an artist, I think we feel like okay, art speaks for itself. I'm just going to step away and let it speak, right? But then what I've learned as I've done this just for a few years, I started seriously pursuing and doing fine art around 2005. What do you do? What's your technique? How long does it take? Why do you choose the subjects that you choose? Those kinds of things. So I'm going to make some assumptions that those are the kinds of things you guys would like to know too. But please ask questions at the end of this. I set my timer for no longer than 10 minutes. I'm going to get off here. These are small works that you haven't come up to see. I'm just going to pass it around so you guys can see them up close. But I do work in pen and ink primarily. Tools, I brought those along to you. Super simple. Plastic tray for ink. Simple pens. You guys have probably seen these around, right? They're great. I love them because the tips actually wear down and fray and break and do all kinds of interesting things that then get carried into the drawings. I like to work with a little bit more toothy paper so that it actually does that damage over time to the pen, because I don't want a super clean line. You know, like if I was a colorful artist, I might not have a perfect line. But for the work that I do, I almost like to feather the edges of the line if I can. And I work with a 0.005 or a 0.01. I use just a couple of traditional brushes like this for ink washes in the background. That's about it. I mean, it's clean, it's a mess, no fuss. See, I'm not like the thick, craziest, messiest artist. I tend to be kind of buttoned up. My desk is neat, my work is neat, I like to keep things that way. But it works for me, right? It's like when I go into my studio, I can just take the cap off my pen and go. That's what I accepted as everything. What's funny is that when I meet people that are like, you're an artist, I'm not too sure you're not like an accountant or something. Artists live in all types, right? So the pen and ink work that I do, I'm just going to pass this around so you guys can see, is mostly made up. I just, I don't use a lot of reference, and I don't draw from reference, I draw from memory, and or from just making up the stories. And I do that because, for me, they create something a little bit different than I'm just trying to capture the image in front of me. There's some kind of a mood that works its way into the drawings that I can't explain. I don't understand where it comes from. But it's there. We know that somehow something's just not quite right. Maybe the perspective's off, maybe trees don't look like real trees. I don't know. It's not exactly surreal, it's not exactly representation, but it's something, it's its own thing, I guess. So the subjects are simple. They're typically houses, trees, stuff like that. And I think, I don't really know why that's the subject matter I keep going back to over and over and over, but I don't plan out the drawings. I just sit down on a piece of paper and start putting pen to paper and see where it seems to want to go. Sometimes that line will suggest right off the bat, okay, that's going to be a structure. Or that's going to be some kind of, I don't know what it's going to be, but let's go with it. And it's like, if it's almost like if the drawing's in a good mood, we're going to get something. If the drawing's not in a good mood, it's just going to be that way. How's it going to come back to that later or something. I feel like drawings kind of have a life of their own, and they sort of dictate where they're going to go without any control of the drawing. And I'm sure what else to tell you guys about it other than, you know, I find creating to be sort of meditative and therapeutic. You get lost in the work. And then if you're half a year or a little older as artists, you probably experience that feeling right where you're just going to get lost in that drawing. And I find it does the same thing for me. Most of my drawings are pretty small. I like images that pull me in. So if I'm in a gallery and can't see it from far away, for me personally, I like that. I like to kind of have to walk up and see what they need here. That's what I'm doing. And then all of a sudden, I feel like my focus has just gone right into that image. So most are small. I have done a few large pieces. I don't know if they're successful or not. They were probably maybe 4 feet tall, maybe 2 feet wide. There's one at the convention center, ship up one, and probably pick up one, one more larger. Those took me like 3 months to do versus maybe 5 hours or something. But when I did the larger drawings, I did the same size pen, so I'm still using super fine lines. It's just going to take a while or something. I don't have a lot of patience for that, so I tend to be like, I got to get to this. I like the immediacy of pen, and I like the commitment of it. It's, and when you put it down, that's it. You know, you're not pulling it back up. So you got to make that thing work the first time. You can kind of solve them a little bit. You can work the lines, you can layer the lines and stuff. But after that, you're either going to overwork it or you've got to move on. So, and I've been doing pen work since